Once rich with the spoils of oil and gas, today many rural communities in southwest Arkansas are fighting for survival after decades of both industry and residents moving away. Now there's new hope of revival, though some are cautious. The area sits on top of what's called the Smackover Formation, a geological formation that spans from Florida to Texas. Thousands of feet below the ground is lithium, a mineral used in the batteries that power electric cars and mobile phones and other things. Our correspondent, Jessica Gomez, traveled to Arkansas to get a look at how companies are now racing to extract the lithium from these towns and what it could mean for the people who live there.
Thank you all for spending your afternoon with us.
In rural Lafayette County, Arkansas, a packed town hall meeting.
Today's technology allows you to drill multiple wells.
Texas-based Tetra Technologies, partnering with energy giant ExxonMobil, laying out plans to start drilling for lithium here. The meeting hosted by County Judge Valerie Clark.
You drive downtown and you just think, oh, they really don't have a lot to offer.
Lafayette County, a place where memories of its heyday, fueled long ago by oil and gas, are fading, along with signs of economic life.
As the county judge, we are over the finances and the road departments.
Clark grew up here and remembers when things were different, before the hospital shut its doors.
Here you go. Y'all have a good day.
When there were more than just a couple of restaurants and plenty of grocery stores. Today, there's just one left. Investors, Clark says, just aren't interested.
They just pretty much flat out told me, you don't have the population for another grocery store.
But that could change as companies race to extract lithium from the saltwater or brine found thousands of feet below the Earth's surface here. The demand for the mineral, critical for the renewable energy market, is expected to soar over the next two decades. Nearly 95% of the world's lithium supply comes from just four countries: Australia, Chile, China, and Argentina. Only 1% of lithium used in the U.S. is produced domestically.
60 million liters of brine have been run through this plant.
To the east in El Dorado, Standard Lithium, CEO Robert Mintak.
It's in your iPhone, it's in your laptop, it's in your tablet. Without the lithium-ion battery, the technology that we take for granted every day would not exist.
The company perfecting direct lithium extraction from that underground saltwater. The brine already pumped to the Earth's surface by another company that produces bromine, a chemical used in products like flame retardant and cleaning supplies.
They extract that bromine and they put the brine back in the ground. They've been doing that in South Arkansas for 60 years. It's the same brine that's rich with lithium.
But Mintak says refining and converting lithium for commercial use is a complex and costly process. And while it could bring hundreds of jobs to the region, it won't happen overnight.
South Arkansas has got a rich energy heritage, boom and bust. We're looking to not repeat that cycle. Being prepared is going to be critical for the community's success.
You know, farm life out here is pretty neat.
On the Alford Cattle Ranch, though, it's been a rough few years.
The feed's higher, the grain's higher, everything's higher.
So when a handful of companies asked Bruce and Linda Alford to lease their land to drill for bromine and now lithium, they agreed. 2,100 acres so far.
And they come up and offering you money and you have a possibility of making royalty and everything else on it, I think you would lease.
But they still have questions. The Arkansas Oil and Gas Commission has yet to determine what percentage of any profits landowners would make. And the Alfords worry about the environment.
I don't know what kind of condition that might leave us in. Our kids are here. Our grandkids are probably going to be right here. We want it to be a good place to live.
What kind of problems are we going to have with water systems, like well water?
And while there are more questions, many, like Akili Moses Israel with the local community college, hope it could mean real opportunities not seen around here in decades.
We're trying to move that from I just need a job to I have the opportunity to have a career of my choosing.
I truly envision that these stores, they will find new life again, and someone will come in and open them back up. They will be vibrant.
A future, Valerie Clark believes, could be even better than the past. In Lafayette County, Arkansas, for matter of fact, I'm Jessica Gomez.